Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network. Heart Softeners by Sheikh Mu'izz Bukhari.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My dear respected elders, brothers, sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa usalli wa usallimu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen, nabijina wa habibina wa qurrati a'yunina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi afdalu salati wa atamu taslim, amma ba'd. As always, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this gathering a gathering where the angels shroud us with their wings, the sakina, tranquility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends upon us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala envelop us with His rahmah, and may He make high mention of us in the seven heavens. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah ta'ala, the heart softener for tonight will be about shukr, about gratitude. Because it is incumbent upon us to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the numerous favors and bounties that He has conferred upon us. The numerous bounties that He has blessed us with. And even if we were to try and count these blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would fail miserably to enumerate all of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He Himself, Azza wa Jal, rightfully states in the Noble Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. That if you were to try and count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you were to try and enumerate the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would not be able to encompass all of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Even if we were to be in sajda, in shukr towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our whole lives, even that would not suffice as showing gratitude to our powerful Maker for all of the blessings that He has conferred upon us. But nevertheless, it is upon us as slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be thankful and to show gratitude unto our beloved and powerful Maker. My beloved Shaykh Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he states from one of the Salafus Salih, one of our pious predecessors, he says that if you want to try and understand the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or recognize the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, just close your eyes for a moment. Just close your eyes for a moment. What happens? When you close your eyes, everything around you is pitch darkness. Everything around you is pitch black. You can't see anything. From this we understand what a great bounty and what a great blessing our eyesight is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us such beautiful eyesight where we see with so much of clarity. This is just one blessing. If you were to look around ourselves, basically everything around us is a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are wallowing in an ocean of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our lives are entirely permeated, i.e. saturated in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, the more we show gratitude unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us. As He states in the Quran, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you show gratitude unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He states, لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. I will definitely give you an increase. I will give you many fold. Allahu Akbar. وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ. But on the other hand, if you deny, if you reject the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Inna azabi la shadid. Indeed, my punishment is severe. Allahu Akbar. My torment is severe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from His anger and from His punishment. I wish to share with you all a story. A story that took place many, many moons ago. A story that was narrated to us by our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this story is recorded in Bukhari. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that there were three individuals, there were three men whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test. So Allah the Almighty sent down an angel to test these three individuals. These three individuals were one a leper, two a blind man, and a bald man. A leper, a bald man, and a blind man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down an angel to test these three individuals. The angel goes to the leper first. He goes to this leper, a person who is afflicted with leprosy. His skin is afflicted with a rash. He is not a pleasant sight to look. People don't like to be by him because of his disease. The angel goes to him, you know, like Aladdin and the magic lamp. He goes to him and says, "What do you wish? Do you have a wish?" The leper, naturally, he's suffering from a very troublesome disease. He wants to come out of it. He says, "I wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cures me of this disease." Hadith is in Bukhari. The angel prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah the Almighty cures that individual completely from his disease, leprosy. Allahu Akbar. And then the wishes don't stop. "What else do you wish?" The leper then says, or the angel asks him, "What do you wish from wealth? What do you wish from wealth?" To which the leper says, "I wish that I be blessed with plenty of camels." Allahu Akbar. "I want herds of camels." The angel prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the individual is blessed with a pregnant she-camel that gives birth, multiplies, and now he owns herds of camels. Allahu Akbar. Now the angel goes to the bald man and he asks the bald man, "What do you wish?" The bald man says, "Naturally, I'm suffering because I don't have hair. I wish to have beautiful long hair." The narration goes along the lines of these words. The angel prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the man is blessed with beautiful hair. And then the angel asks him, "What do you wish from wealth?" He says, I wish to own cows and bulls." Allahu Akbar. Then the angel prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is blessed with a pregnant cow. That cow gives birth, multiplies, and now he owns cows and bulls. The angel now goes to the blind man and asks him, "What do you wish?" "I wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restores my eyesight back so that I'll be able to see things with clarity." The angel prays to Allah. The man is blessed with his eyesight. And now the angel asks him, "What do you wish from wealth?" He says, "I wish to own flocks of sheep." The angel prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is blessed with a pregnant sheep that gives birth, multiplies, and now he owns flocks of sheep. After some time, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the angel to test them. Allah gave them bounties. Allah opened the doors of blessings for them. And now comes the test. Now comes the trial. The angel goes to the leper in the guise of a leper. The angel goes to the man who was a leper before in the guise of a person who has been afflicted with leprosy. And he goes to that man and says, "Oh, slave of Allah, do you see I'm afflicted with leprosy? Can you help me out? I see you have a lot of wealth. Please help me out." The man says, "What? What are you doing here? Get out of here. All of this wealth, I earned it with my hard work. I put in a lot of elbow grease to get all of this wealth. This is mine. Get out of here." He chases the angel. The angel goes to the bald man. And then he says, "O slave of Allah," he goes in the guise of a bald man. He says, "Look at me. I've been afflicted by a disease. Please help me out." The bald man says, "You see, all this wealth, I inherited it. It belongs to my forefathers. This is my wealth. I have nothing to give you. Get out from here." Allahu Akbar. The angel now goes to the blind man and he says, "Oh, slave of Allah, help me out." He goes in the guise of a blind man. I'm blind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with all of this wealth. Please help me out." That man, he says, "You know what? I used to be a blind man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He blessed me so much. He gave me back my eyesight. He gave me all of this wealth that you see around me. You take whatever you wish, because all of that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. The angel then says, this was a test by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your two friends, they failed the test, and Allah the Almighty is angered with them. Allahu Akbar. But you succeeded in this test, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with you. So my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, whatever you see around you is from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not ever leave or do not ever turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without showing gratitude unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Salafun as-Salih, some of them are reported to have said that shukr is basically to feast your eyes on the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with a sense of reverence towards the mun'im, towards the one who gave you that bounty, that blessing. Say you have this blessing in front of you, it is upon you to feast your eyes on that blessing whilst having the reverence for the one who gave you that blessing. Allahu Akbar. Another righteous person is reported to have said that shukr is to focus your attention towards the source of the benefit, towards the source of the bounty, and not to focus your attention onto the bounty itself. Say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with wealth. If Allah the Almighty has opened the doors of wealth for you, do not focus on the wealth. Do not get overwhelmed by the wealth. Do not let the wealth enter your heart, but rather focus your attention towards the giver, towards the one who gave you that wealth, and show gratitude unto him and love him. Fill your heart with the love for that creator, Allahu Akbar. And if you do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of barakat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of goodness for you, resulting in whatever that blessing may be, it will be multiplied many fold for you. Allahu Akbar. I have one final story, and this took place in the lives of our Salafun as-Salih. There was once a man who was journeying, and he passed by a sheikh. He asked that the sheikh was an old man. He was around 70 to 80 years of age. He asked him, "Ya sheikh, please tell me something from your life." Then the sheikh says, "You know, young lad, when I was young, I was madly in love with my cousin sister. I was madly in love with my cousin sister. And she too, likewise, she was madly in love with me. We loved one another. We didn't do anything haram. What we did was, we approached our parents and we ended up marrying one another. We married. Now, we were madly in love with one another. We married. And on the night of the marriage, when I entered the room of my bride, she told me, 'Oh, my dear husband, let us spend this night, instead of spending it together, let us spend it in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a gesture of shukr, as a gesture of gratitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who brought us together. Let us spend this night in worship.' To which I agreed, and we spent the night completely in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The following night, too, we spent it in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The night after that, the night after that, the night after that, and today, I am 80 years old or 70 years old. Every single night, me and my wife and I, we have been spending it in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we still feel that this is not enough gratitude shown to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, do not turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Show gratitude unto him, and he will bless you in your lives, in this world as well as the hereafter. And with that we conclude. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins. And we ask him the Almighty to accept our good deeds. And we ask him also to unite us, just as how he united us here tonight in the gardens of Jannah with our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhir da'waya anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khair.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate and stay updated by joining our network's social links.